Hey everyone, so welcome back to my channel again. This video is very, very important as we are going to introduce a new topic from the chapter sequence and series. What is sequence in mathematics? You have learned about arithmetic progression, you have learned about geometric progression, maybe you have learned about some other series also, like triangular number series or square number series or like that. You have done series type questions, but what is series? Before that, you have to understand what is a sequence. Okay, how we are dealing sequence in our day-to-day life. So we have good examples in the video. Please go through the video completely, and so let's start the video.
Sequence in mathematics. Sequence you have in your day-to-day life also. Sequence you have in mathematics also. In day-to-day life, suppose a writer is writing a book, so he will start with page number 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and so on. So there is a set pattern that he has to start with page number 1, then he will move to 2, then to 3, then 4, and so on. He can't do that like he is starting with page number 1, then he will reach to 93. No, first there is an introduction, then there is a story, then there is an end, then there is a moral of the story. So this is a complete set pattern. So when you are ordered the things or numbers in a set pattern, so that is called the sequence. Suppose I am, and there is an architecture who make houses. Suppose he has made 3 houses. So he will start either from the left or right to write the numbers. This is house number 1, this is house number 2, this is house number 3. So either he will start from left or right, that is his choice or her choice. But there is a set pattern that after house number 1, there is a 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and so on, right? So this is a day-to-day life examples. But what about in mathematics? When we are writing elements, when we are writing numbers in a sequence, when we are talking about the sequence in mathematics, mean we are writing the numbers with a set pattern. Suppose I am saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So whenever I'm writing sequence, I'm writing with commas. So between 2 terms, there is a comma. It means there is a set pattern that in every previous term, I am adding 1. So when I'm adding 1 to 1, I'm getting 2. When I'm getting, when I'm adding 1 to 2, then I'm getting 3, and so on. It means I'm doing a regular thing in every previous step to get the next step. Means every step is dependent upon the previous step. Every term is completely dependent upon the previous term, that you have to understand. Please remember this thing, okay? Whenever you are writing a sequence, it means every term is completely dependent upon the previous term. Successive term is dependent upon the previous term, right? Now, please understand the definition of the sequence, that it is a set of ordered things. It is not necessary that sequence is in mathematics only. It can be in day-to-day life. Like I have given you the example of a book writer, or I have given you an example of an architecture. Certain pattern, it is very important. I can't write 2, 93, 1, 5, minus 1. This is not a sequence because there is no set pattern. Okay, because 2, 93, 1, there is no set pattern. So I can't, this is not a sequence. But if I am writing 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on, there is a set pattern. What is the set pattern? That in every previous term, I am adding 2 to get the next term. Okay, I am getting the next term. So every successive term is completely dependent upon the next term, previous term, sorry. So there is a set pattern. And also in sequence, successive term is dependent upon the previous term. So what is the sequence? It is an arrangement of sorting of things or numbers, but with a certain pattern, right? Suppose a very great example, suppose in this almira, and you have 100 shirts, and I told you that please arrange these shirts in the form of Vibhyor. So first you will arrange violet shirts, then you will arrange indigo, then blue, then green, then yellow, then orange, and then red, okay? So this is the set pattern, right? So that is the sequence, right? Now, let's take a very important thing about sequence is a function. Sequence is a function of natural numbers with codomain as the set of real numbers. So there are many things. First, how sequence is a function. So it's very, very important to understand that how sequence is a function. So first, what is a function? What is a function? Function means you have an input and you have an output. Okay, you have an input and you have an output. So means function in mathematics, you are showing by y is equals to f of x. Means you are giving some x and you are getting some y. That is a function. So suppose I'm taking the same sequence 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on. Every next term is completely dependent upon the previous one, because every this term I am getting by adding 2 to the previous term. So this is the sequence. Why it is a function? Because in 1, I am giving an input of plus 2 because I am adding 2 to the previous term. So x, this is the input, right? So as per this, what is the function here? So function is 2n minus 1. Okay, so there is a complete, whenever you have a sequence, so there is a complete formula for that. For this sequence, I have a formula y is equals to 2n minus 1. If n is equals to 1, then what will be the y? So 2 into 1 minus 1, which is 2 minus 1, which is 1. So y is equals to 1. When n is equals to 2, what will be the value of y? So 2 into 2 minus 1, which is 3. When n is equals to 3, y is equals to 2 into 3 minus 1, which is 5, and so on. It means you are giving an input. How you are giving an input? You are giving input first 1, then 2, then 3, and so on. And you are getting an output like 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, then 9, and so on. Right? So means sequence is a function. Means you are giving an input and you are getting an output. So this is a function. Right? Now, what is codomain, domain, and range in a sequence? So you are giving an input, you are getting an output. This is the domain. Whatever the input you are giving, that is the domain. Whatever the answers you are getting, the output you are getting, that is the range. Always remember. And very important thing, which is that domain will always be a natural number. Domain, that is the input, is always a natural number. Suppose, for example, I have 5 seats or 5 houses, you can say. I will say, Joy, that you will take house number 2. I can't say that I'm allotting you a house number minus 2. There is no such number. Okay, so whenever we are talking about a sequence, so we'll start with, this is term number 1, A1. This is term 2. This is term 3. This is term 4. So input will always be a natural number. And output can be any real number. It can be positive. It can be negative. It can be decimal number. It can be any integer. Okay. So it can be any real number. So this is natural. Input is natural always. And output is a real number. Right. So this is very, very important to understand. Next important thing that you have to understand is, every element in a sequence, that suppose this is first element, second element, third element, fourth element, and so on, these called as the term. Term 1, term 2, term 3, term 4, and so on. Very important. So every element in the sequence is called as the term. Suppose I'm saying this is a set sequence. So this is term 1, term 2, term 3, term 4, and so on. Next very important thing, sequence can be finite, infinite. If I'm writing a sequence up till 4 terms. So this is the finite because I am ending here only. Because they are finite terms, infinite series which goes on and on and on. But how we should know that it goes on and on and on? With the 3 dots. If you have 3 dots after the last number, it means this is an infinite series, right? So with the 3 dots, we are telling that this is an infinite series. So this is all. So sequence are of 2 types. One is finite, and then we have infinite. And next we have is the, yes, we have discussed about sequence is a function, which is very, very important. So one video I will take about how sequence is a function, but I already told in this video. I think it's very much clear to you. So this is all about sequence. After you are getting sequence, then we will move to series, because series is completely dependent upon the sequence. When you have sequence, then only you have series. Otherwise, you don't have series, right? So yeah, this is all about the sequence, everyone. If you have any problem, please write in the comment box that you don't understand something or like that. So thank you. Thank you so much.